In our mind, we start to realize that we're concerned, we're afraid, we don't have enough, I'm not safe, I'm not secure. And I say, oh, these thoughts, I was talking about the thoughts in your mind, go in and control your biology, your genetics, your physiology, and your health. And I go, yes, this is really true. I say, well, how can I tell you what your thoughts are in a sense that can I read your thoughts? And I say, yes, you know, I could put wires on your head, and it's called electroencephalograph, and I could read your brain activity. And I go, oh, great, I can see this brain activity. I want to tell you something that's profoundly important. We were programmed to believe that our thoughts are contained in our head. That if I have a thought, it's just for me, not for anybody else. It's inside and it's working through me. And now I want to tell you about a new technology. It's not electroencephalograph, it's called magnetoencephalograph. I say, what's unique about that? I say, it reads your brain. I say, yeah, but so does EEG. I say, yeah, but EEG, you put the wires on the head and you get the electrical activity conducted through the skin from the brain, and that's what I'm reading. And I say, what's different about MEG? The probe is out here. And I said, what does that mean? Your thoughts are not contained in your head. Your thoughts are broadcast to the field, just like a radio broadcast. I said, well, what if I, as an individual, have a thought that says, let's have peace in the world. And I broadcast out there in the street and I say, let's have peace. And I look around, it's like, where's the peace? I don't see the peace. And here's what the relevance is. Each of us is broadcasting. If you get enough people to have the same thought, that broadcast is amplified. Each of us has a small power, but if you put 1,000 people with the same thought, 10,000, 100,000 people with the same thought, you are broadcasting a most powerful thought, not just in your body, but out in the field. I say, your energy is in the field, the thought is in the field. And you go, well, what does that mean? And then I'll give you this most wonderful quote. I used it the other day in a lecture from Albert Einstein. And the quote is so important. Here's the quote. The field, so a definition, the field is the invisible energy. Right now you're in a field, there's cell phone broadcasts, television, radio broadcasts, all kinds of information coming across, but guess what? Each one of you is a broadcast in that field. The quote, the field is the sole governing agency of the particle. Particle is the material realm. So what was Einstein saying? It's the energy in the field that shapes the physical experience of our lives. And if enough of us collectively have an energy that's coherent and strong, and we broadcast the belief, we change the world. I just want you to recognize, as much as I wanted peace in the world, if not enough people are out there saying, let's have peace in the world, there is no peace. If I want to say, let's have a war, how can you have a war? You have to have enough people convinced that the war is going to benefit them so that their broadcast say, yes, let's have a war because I and my colleagues, we're all going to have a better result from that. And the reality is this. The only things that change on this planet collectively are when we collectively share thoughts. And yoga, when you're in your postures, when you're in your process, your mind is sharing a thought, not just in your head, but all around you. So the whole idea about this is we have to recognize we are collectively creating reality with our thoughts. And if we want to change reality, it can change instantly. The moment we become coherent, the moment we collectively are on the same platform of thinking, you get enough people to say peace, there will be peace instantly in this world. But we've been programmed by other people to give them the power to tell us what we need. And as Sadhguru has been telling us so importantly, what we need is not what they tell us, what we need is what we know. And I really hope that you understand this, because when you have your thoughts, recognize it's not contained in your head, your thoughts out in the field. And that thought, the field, is the sole governing agency of matter. And therefore, what this world is looking for at this moment is an evolution. It's not an evolution of our biology. Our biology is already evolved. It's an evolution of our consciousness. When we collectively as a population say enough is enough, it will end. And when we say to our Mother Ganga and we say to the nature that we're living in, we're sorry we have been destroying you, but now we are here to help. This planet will be restored in what is called a spontaneous remission. A spontaneous remission? A person could be dying of cancer and everybody's looking around and all of a sudden the patient changes their belief and says, I'm not doing this, I'm doing something different. And guess what? How fast does it take that thought to change your cancer into peace again? It's called spontaneous remission. It will spontaneously change the planet. We are experiencing the groundswell of an evolution. And every one of you is a most important contributor to that evolution. Because when you recognize your thoughts are creating this, and we collectively agree that this is not what we want, what we want is a garden that we were given, the garden will instantly, spontaneously reappear. So our evolution is not waiting for something to happen. Our evolution is each one of us is a participant. It's not sit in your seat and wait for the evolution, look out your window. No, we are making evolution. So look at yourself as a powerful force, an energy, a belief and a thought that will create the world that we collectively want, not a world that has been programmed by a small number of people and then programmed us with their belief. I trust you more than any government. I trust you more than any corporation, because all of us really want the same thing. Peace, love, harmony, joy. And if we all broadcast that thought, the universe will express it and we will return to the garden. So I really want to thank you, because when you understand this, you'll start to recognize we don't have to be victims. We just need to change our thoughts. Thank you.